Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel focused on PLC programming using Codesys. In this tutorial, I'll walk you through the steps of inspecting and, if needed, adjusting the execution order in CFC or continuous function chart programming language. I trust you will find the video tutorial both informative and enjoyable. Remember to give it a like, drop a comment, share it with your network, and don't hesitate to reach out if you have any questions. Thanks for joining, and let's delve into the content.
Let us first have a look at the execution order of the code in LD, FBD, IL, ST, and SFC. In the ladder logic diagram, the code is executed from left to the right and from top to the bottom. In function block diagram, the execution of the code is similar to ladder logic, from left to the right and from top to the down. In the case of the instruction list, the instructions are evaluated line by line. So first, we start by evaluating the first line. Here we have the instruction of loading, and then the next one in the same network is executed. And after the execution of one rung or network is finished, the execution continues with the next rung. In the case of structured text, the expression to the right side of the assignment operator is evaluated, and then its value is copied into the variable in the left side of the assignment operator. And in general, the execution starts from the first line and it continues going downwards until we reach the last line. Please also keep in mind that we have some operators to control the flow of the code or the execution flow of the code. For example, for loops, while loops, if statements, and so on and so forth, or jump, for example, which is available in instruction list, in function block diagram, and also in the ladder logic. Then we have the sequential function chart. In this case, the execution starts from the init step, and then it continues depending on the conditions that we have for the transitions, and also the branches, whether we have parallel branches or normal branches, and then if we have a jump to a specific step at any point. And finally, regarding the continuous function chart, the execution order might be a little bit different, because here you have the freedom in terms of placing the networks. So each one of these is indeed a network in any place in the editor. Yeah? So you can move them around, and by default, the execution order is similar to what we have with the FBD, so from left to the right and from top to bottom. Therefore, the execution order considers the data flow and the topological location of the network. However, there is an option to change this and prioritize the execution of a given block or set the execution order manually. To demonstrate this, I have created a project with CFC as the programming language, and I have placed several blocks in the code. As you can see, I have two separate networks. One includes two on-delay timers, and the second one includes two add blocks. By default, the execution order is based on the data flow. We can check this by right-clicking on the POU, choosing Properties, in the CFC Execution Order tab. In the execution order field, we see that auto data flow mode is selected. So this is the default execution order mode. In this mode, the order in which the blocks are executed is determined based on the data flow. And if there is more than one network, like the one that we have here, the execution order is based on the topological position of the networks. We can display the order of the execution of the blocks by right-clicking in an empty area in the editor, choosing execution order, and then display execution order. The order in which the blocks are being executed is now shown by numbers, starting from 0. If you click on the editor again, the numbers will disappear. You can see here that if I move the networks around and change their topological order, the execution order changes as well. First, the network containing add blocks is on the top of the other one, and therefore it's being executed first, as seen by the execution order numbers. Then, I change the topological position of the networks, I move the network with two add blocks below the other network with two undelay timer blocks, and then double check the execution order. Now you see that the network containing undelay timers will be executed first, and then the other block will be executed. Another point to check here is important for the networks including the feedback path. In this case, if you right click on a block, in the execution order menu, there is this option to set start of feedback. If I choose it, a green small square will be shown in the corner of the block, and it determines that this block will be executed first and its output will be used by the other blocks in the network. To update the execution order, I will move this network once downwards. And if I show the display execution order, you will see that this block will be executed first and then the other block in the network will be executed afterwards. To remove it, you can right click again on the block and choose set start of feedback again, and then it will disappear, and afterwards the execution order will be determined based on the data flow. Now you see that the first block is executed and then the second block. The second mode for determining the execution order is called Explicit Execution Order mode. You can choose this option by right clicking on the POU, choosing the properties, CFC execution order, and then in the execution order, you can choose this explicit execution order mode, and then click on OK. Then the execution order for all blocks in the editor will be shown permanently. In this case, changing the topology of the networks will not change the execution order. So if I move this network downwards or upwards again, you see that the execution order is not updated. It doesn't change. If I want to get the execution order updated, I can right click here again in the execution order, choose order by data flow. When I do that, you see that this network will be executed first and then the second network will be executed. So we have that option of updating the execution order according to the data flow whenever needed. In this mode, if you select any block and right click on it, in the execution order, there are several options to choose. Send to front, send to back, move up and move down, and then set execution order. If I choose send to front, the execution order of this block will be set to 0, meaning that it will be the first block in the POU to be evaluated. Then if I choose send to back, its execution order will be set to the highest number, which is 5 here, and it means that this will be the last block to be evaluated in the POU. If I choose move up, the execution order will be reduced by 1, or it will be decremented by 1. Each time that I choose it, it will be decremented by 1. And if I choose move down, its execution order will be incremented by 1. And for the remaining ones, their execution order will be updated accordingly. I also have this option of setting the execution order manually. Here you see the current execution order is 4, and I have the option of choosing a number between 0 to 5. If I choose 2, please pay attention to the execution order of this add block here, which is already equal to. It will be updated once I change the execution order of this undelay timer. So this now has become 2, and that add has the third position in terms of the order of the execution. Please keep in mind that it's always better to stick to the automatic mode of setting the execution order, as it is the optimal solution. However, you have the option of setting the orders manually if you need to do so. That wraps up this tutorial. I hope you found the video both enjoyable and informative. Please be sure to subscribe to the channel, give the video a like, leave a comment and share it with your network. Thank you for your time, and I look forward to connecting with you in the next one. Until then, take care and goodbye for now.